As part of a luncheon held at the May Lodge in Floyd County, Kentucky Attorney General Daniel Cameron spoke with local leaders about recent efforts within the Commonwealth. During the luncheon, Cameron spoke on issues ranging from human trafficking, COVID-19 legislation, and advancements in the opioid epidemic.
I also note that our human trafficking unit has made progress in tracking down and apprehending traffickers in Kentucky. Some of you might know, and the governor and myself just announced the completed Operation United Front, which we rescued 21 human trafficking victims, two of which were minors, and arrested 46 suspected human traffickers. Like many of our most successful projects, this operation was the result of collaboration amongst our local, state, and federal law enforcement community. Because of their actions, there are parents in our state that can sleep better tonight, knowing that some predator is not trying to exploit their child.
Later, Cameron spoke with Mountaintop about possible steps in fighting the opioid epidemic.
What I hoped to communicate with the remarks I provided or gave in there, and what I've been trying to articulate to folks, is that ending the opioid epidemic, ending the drug epidemic, and I use the word drug because opioids continue to be a big driver, but now we're seeing meth, we're seeing a resurgence in meth, we're seeing pressed pills, maybe they have fentanyl or carfentanil in them, that are having just as dangerous consequences for folks that ingest them. So my view is that we need a two-pronged approach. We need interdiction, we need our law enforcement to continue locking up the bad guys and the traffickers that are pushing this poison into our communities. But we also need to make sure that we're holding accountable any distributors or wholesalers that help exacerbate the problem. And so what we've done in the AG's office, and not only our office, other AG offices across the country, have joined on to a global settlement, if you will, that will bring in excess of $482 million to Kentucky to help with what I call abatement or rehabilitation services, training, transportation, education, things that can help restore hope and help people that have found themselves in the cycle of addiction. That money, I'm hopeful, when it's split between state government and the counties and cities, will help break those cycles of addiction, and ultimately we can push back and turn the tide against this epidemic.
For Mountaintop News, I'm Joel Cordial.